This is Catherine Schmer at Chattanooga State Community College. This is video 3 of three-dimensional coordinate systems. In this video, we talk about the distance between points in 3D. So in this figure that I just put up, we have points P1 and P2. Point P1 is the point X1, Y1, Z1. And point 2 is the point X2, Y2, Z2. Now to get the distance formula, we're going to use the Pythagorean theorem. So we also need to define points A and B. Point A is the point X2, Y1, Z1. And point B is the point X2, Y2, Z1. So we get the formula from the Pythagorean theorem applied to triangles P1AB and P1BP2. I'll do this on the next slide so that you can see how we achieve the formula. The distance between points P1 and P2 is written as a vertical bar, P1, P2, and another vertical bar. It looks like absolute value, but in this case, it's talking about the length between P1 and P2. So the length of the line segment P1, P2, or in other words, the distance between P1 and P2, is equal to the square root of X2 minus X1 squared plus Y2 minus Y1 squared plus Z2 minus Z1 squared. Now, let's look at how we actually get this formula. So we have the same figure as on the last slide, and we want to derive the distance formula. So if we look at this triangle formed by P1, A, and B, so remember P1 is the point X1, Y1, Z1, A is X2, Y1, Z1, and B is X2, Y2, Z1. So the hypotenuse of that triangle is the length of P1B. Now the side of the triangle between point P1 and A is the absolute value of X2 minus X1. And the side length between A and B is the absolute value of Y2 minus Y1. So if we apply the Pythagorean theorem, we get the distance between P1 and B squared equals the absolute value of X2 minus X1 squared plus the absolute value of Y2 minus Y1 squared. Now let's look at the triangle P1, B, P2. So the hypotenuse of this triangle is the length of P1, P2, line segment P1, P2, and the vertical leg is the absolute value of Z2 minus Z1. Now we know that the other leg of the triangle is the distance between P1 and B, which we already figured using the Pythagorean theorem on the first triangle. So now the distance between P1 and P2 quantity squared, so we're applying the Pythagorean theorem again, equals the distance between P1 and B squared plus the absolute value of Z2 minus Z1 squared. So now we already figured out that P1B magnitude squared is equal to the absolute value of X2 minus X1 squared plus Y2 minus Y1 squared, and then we have the plus Z2 minus Z1 squared. Because we have the squares, we can drop the absolute value. So we just get parentheses X2 minus X1 parentheses squared plus parentheses y2 minus y1 parentheses squared plus parentheses z2 minus z1 parentheses squared. So that gives us the formula, the length of the line segment P1, P2 equals the square root of x2 minus x1 quantity squared plus y2 minus y1 quantity squared plus z2 minus z1 quantity squared. So there's our distance formula. Almost the same as in two dimensions, but we've added a z component. So let's practice with this. We have example 5 from the guided notes, and we want to find the distance between the points negative 4, 3, 2, and 9, 2, 1. So let's label these points P1 and P2. P1 will be negative 4, 3, 2. P2 will be 9, 2, negative 1. So the distance between P1 and P2 equals the square root of 9 minus negative 4 quantity squared plus 2 minus 3 quantity squared plus negative 1 minus 2 quantity squared. So I'm doing x2 minus x1 and y2 minus y1 and z2 minus z1. So I'm plugging those into the formula. So now I just calculate it out, and I see this is the square root of 13 squared plus negative 1 squared plus negative 3 squared, which gives me the square root of 179. So the distance between P1 and P2 in this case is square root of 179.